Yeah, you can. All right, so we'll go Lisa Farbstein, F-A-R-B-S-T-E-I-N, and I'm a spokesperson with the Transportation Security Administration. And so we'll talk a little bit about how to get through the checkpoint as smoothly as possible, with as little hassle as possible. And the first thing is, when you come to the checkpoint, you want to have your boarding pass and your ID out and ready. So that means when you get up to the ticket document checker, that's not the time to look in your handbag, pull out your wallet, where's my ID, oh, here's my ID. It's not the time that you want to be pulling your wallet out. You should already have that out, because if not, people behind you in line are going to be rolling their eyes, they're going to be muttering under their breath because you weren't ready, and it's slowing them down. Once you get past the ticket document checker, you're going to come up to the stainless steel tables, the rollers, and you're going to take off your shoes, right? Take off your shoes, put them either right directly on the rollers, or put them in a bin, right? We recommend that you use slip-on shoes. If you have slip-on shoes, we figure that actually you'll save yourself about a minute, because you're not going to have to bend over, unlace your shoes, and then at the other end of the checkpoint, you're not going to have to get your shoes, find a seat, sit down, put them on, and relace them. So you can actually save yourself a minute if you wear slip-on shoes. So again, put them right on the belt or put them in a bin. Next, we ask that you take out everything from your pockets. Everything from your pockets. Not just the metal, but even things like tissues. Because something this small, this lightweight, can actually alarm the machine, which will result in a pat-down, which will delay you a couple of minutes. So take everything out. We recommend, actually, you put everything from your pockets into your carry-on, whether that's a handbag, whether that's a briefcase, whether that's a duffel bag, because that way you're less likely to leave it behind, less likely to leave it in the bin. We know a lot of people like to travel with little pocket knives, and oftentimes they're hooked onto your keychain, right? That's something you have to try to remember to take off before you come to the airport, right? That's perfect to put in your check bag, but that's not something you want to see in a carry-on bag. That's going to result in a bag check. It's going to slow you down, probably about 3 or 4 minutes. The officer will find that, and you'll be given a choice. Should you put it? You can put it in your check bag. You can put it back to your. You can run it back to your car. Some airports have mailing centers. You can mail it home. You can mail it to your destination. And your last choice will be to surrender it to TSA. So we ask you to try to remember to take it off your keychain. Okay. Also, we know a lot of people have pocket knives. Here we go. This one has a clip on, right? Got a good sturdy clip, right? And oftentimes, people put that, you know, on a handbag. They put it on their pocket or their slacks, or they hook it onto their belt. They put it in a duffel bag. And actually, we know, because it has that clip, that they put that on every morning, just like they put on their wristwatch. And so we ask again that you stop and you think, I'm going to the airport today, I shouldn't put that on my belt, shouldn't put it in my pocket, perfect for you to put in your check bag. Just put it in your check bag, okay? Again, if you leave it on your pocket, then you're going to have to get a pat down. So it's just something else to remind people. We have a 3-1-1 rule. 3-1-1 rule is that you can have three stands for 3.4 ounces or smaller, one quart size bag, one bag per person. So you want to put your liquids, gels, and aerosols in here. Again, they all need to be 3.4 ounces or smaller. But why? Why 3.4 ounces? And the answer is because our intelligence tells us that something this size is not likely to cause a catastrophic incident on an aircraft. Right? However, if you have something this size, a can of soda, a bottle of water, a can of iced tea, whatever it is, liquid this size, if it's an explosive, can cause a catastrophic incident on a plane. Now, just recently, we saw an Egypt airplane disappear from the sky. The folks who claimed responsibility for that said that they used a liquid explosive in a can that looked like a can of soda. Now, while you can't bring your bottled water through because it's not 3-1-1, it's not 3.4 ounces and it doesn't fit in that 3-1-1 bag, you can bring an empty bottle, right? Consider bringing an empty bottle, filling it up on the secure side, and you saved yourself $3 or $4. Okay. The other thing is, consider keeping your 3-1-1 bag in an outer pocket. of your carry-on. If you leave it in your outer pocket, then you're not in here, in your carry-on bag, digging through it. Where did I pack it? Where did I pack it? It'll be much speedier trip through the checkpoint, put it in the outer pocket, and then put it in the bin. Okay? Next is, a lot of people are traveling with their laptops, and actually we're seeing a trend where more and more people are traveling with two and sometimes three laptops. So you want to take your laptop out of its carrying case, put it in its own bin. If you have more than one laptop, each laptop gets its own bin. And why? Why do we do that? That's because people can hide explosives in a device this size. And so we want to make sure our X-ray machine gets a good look, make sure that really is a laptop, and if we can get a better look of what's inside your carry-on bag to make sure that that's clear and doesn't have any prohibited items either. Now, what happens if you accidentally leave your liquid, your bottle of water in your handbag or your duffel bag? What happens if you leave your laptop inside? What happens is, bag check, lane two. All right, and then what happens is TSA officer calls you to the side. They're going to take a cloth. They're going to swab your whole case. They're going to unzip it. They're going to take out the laptop. They're going to swab the whole thing. Then they're going to take that swab and put it into a machine that's going to read to see if there are any traces of explosives. Okay? And so assuming it's none, then they have to go take the carry-on. They have to take the laptop, run to the beginning of the line again, and put the laptop and the carry-on case back through the X-ray machine. That takes about 4 minutes. So you can save yourself that hassle, that 4 minutes, if you pay attention to what the TSA officer is telling you to do. We have TSA officers who are in the line. They're called divestiture officers, and they're telling you, reminding you to divest. Please take your cell phone out. Please take your keys out. Please empty your pockets. Please take your laptop and put it in its own bin. Those folks are worth their weight in gold. Because those individuals, if they are good at what they do, then that means there are going to be fewer pat-downs, there are going to be fewer bag checks. You'd be surprised at how many people come to the checkpoint every day and still have that bottle of water in their carry-on bag. Even though they've been standing in a checkpoint line for 10 minutes, it's not until they get there, they're like, oh yeah, I had that bottle of water in there. Oh yeah, I forgot to take my laptop out. But if you're in the checkpoint, you're in that experience, you're in that environment, really concentrate on what it is you're supposed to do. It'll make your trip go through much smoother.